And this ribbon. I made this bow. To my crappy house. I'm here to show you how to make a kick-ass bow just in time for the holidays. I made this video as a visual aid to go along with a blog post on mycrappyhouse.com. So if you're watching this on the blog, then you're in the right place. If you're watching on YouTube, I'm going to highly recommend that you check out the blog because I'm much better at writing than I am at talking in my stupid voice on a video. I'll also have diagrams and photos there, so I'll link that post in the description below. All right, let's go make a bow. Holiday bows, yo! I like to start on an angle. I think it looks nice. And then you're gonna pinch about 2 inches, 2.5 inches from the start. And your first loop is going to go down and away from your body. And the length of the loop depends on the width of the ribbon. This is a pretty wide ribbon, so it can kind of go maybe out this far. If I go too far, it's going to start getting floppy, so you would want a wider ribbon if you want to do a bigger bow. I'd say right about here is as big as you would want to go for this size ribbon. And so you're holding with your thumb and your index finger, and then you're going to squeak this in. So you're holding that also between your thumb and index finger and crinkle that up and pinch it. So you want to make this loop the same size as the other one that you made and pinch that too. You want to pinch it super tight. You kind of want to wreck the ribbon there. Just pinch it very tight. So it's like a little accordion, little zigzag pinch. So those are your first two back loops, loops 1 and 2. Now you're going to do the next two loops kind of in front of those, not next to them, but kind of in front of them and a tiny bit smaller. You're going away from you on the bottom. And you're going just slightly smaller. You can see this one's a little bit bigger, this one's a little smaller, not much. And you're going to pinch that in place, super tight. And you want to move the ribbon around because you're kind of going in the front with these two loops. And you make another one that's again the same size as that one that you just made. And you're going to pinch that in place. This one is going to be a big loop. You can use the other back loop that you made to make sure it's the same length. And you're going to pinch that in place. And this next loop is the one I call the lightning loop, because this is the only one that's a little strange. But this one loop, this is loop number 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number 6 is going to be a loop-de-loop, like a roller coaster. And this particular loop is the very center of the bow, and it's going to serve to hide the pipe cleaner. So instead of going like this, I'm doing a lightning loop. And your next loop, loop number 7, is another big loop. And you're again gonna, you can hold it with your thumb and forefinger loosely while you make sure it's the right size. And then you're gonna pinch it. Zigzag pinch. And that one's pushed towards the back. So now you have 7 loops. These are in the back, and these 2 are in the back, and then these 3 are towards the front. And we're going to do a front. Turn it away from you. And hold it loosely with your thumb and forefinger while you check the size. You want it to be the same size as one of the front loops. Pinch it in place. And the other front loop. I'm going to do the same thing. Coming towards you now. And you're going to check the size. And pinch that in place. And then your last 2 loops will be back loops. And you want to match that size again. And last loop up at the top. Match the size. And now you can cut your bow free. I like to do it on an angle because I think it looks pretty. And I always like to put tails on my bows. You don't have to. You can just make them the loops and leave the tail out of it, but I think a tail looks pretty. So take a length of ribbon and then you're gonna pinch it in place and match it so that they're about the same size. And then you take a pipe cleaner or a wire or whatever, and you're gonna secure where you pinched everything. But remember this loop, the lightning loop, this one actually goes over the pinch. So you have to put your pipe cleaner through that loop. And then you're gonna tuck it underneath your thumb. You're still holding with your forefinger. I have an extra finger holding there too. And then you're gonna bend it to the back. And you want it to be super tight. So you're gonna grab onto both sides of the wire, pipe cleaner, pulling against it, and you're gonna pinch it closed like that. Put your hand behind the bow and hold it all. It's okay if you squish it, you're not gonna hurt it. And then twist that. You don't have to have it this long, but you can always cut it after, and this way you can attach it to a wreath or Christmas tree, whatever. So now you've got your bow, and wire-edged ribbon makes it very easy to shape. So you're just going to go back and you're going to shape all of your loops. Really about as big as you can go with this ribbon. I think smaller would have been a little bit better for comparison. Here's the other bow that I made. It's a little bit smaller, I think. Anyway, that's how you make a kick-ass bow. If you like this video and you're not on the blog right now, then you're missing out on some quality bow making extras. Just click the link in the description to check that out. And next time you see a $15 bow in a craft store, you could save your money, because now you know.